Hello, welcome again to channel 48. Thank you for tuning in. And today it's about the G531F. Yoel, I remember buying this phone about 1 year ago. And since I bought it, I made some videos about some ROMs. And there is only one Lineage OS available for this phone, and that's Lineage OS 13. And I showed that ROM, but the problem with that ROM is that it will never ever be updated because of the chip that is being used, the Marvel chip in this device. Marvel is not giving any information about the changes that they did in the AOSP sources, you know, to make the hardware work. So if they don't give no information, then in fact a developer cannot continue. It's the same thing with Huawei phones. If you buy a Huawei phone, you know, you cannot unlock the bootloader because they are not giving unlock codes anymore. So you will never be able to create a ROM for the thing. You understand? But if you don't know the sources of the hardware, then developers can as well do nothing for the device. So this is one of these devices, and I bought it for $25, and it was a really cool deal, because when I got this phone in the middle of nowhere, those that follow my channel, they will know the story. The lady, after I paid her the €25, you know, for the phone, and she went picking it up, she came back with the A310F phone in her hands that was not turning on anymore because it fell in the toilet. And she said that she brought it to a phone shop to get it repaired, and they could not fix it. And if I wanted it, I thought, you know, even as a dummy, it would be a nice phone after cleaning it good, of course. But she already did. You know, it would still look good in the studio, you know, just like a dummy of the 310. But then I came home and I start charging it, and then, you know, suddenly the thing, I saw activity, and I went into the recovery mode, did some things, gifted some slaps, and suddenly the thing turned on. And until the day of today, you know, it's working and it's running Android 10 from Denwood, you know, one of my favorite developers from XDA at this moment. But this phone that I went for was not so fortunate, because in the first place it was FRP locked. I had to do all sorts of crazy things because the boy did not remember, the son of the woman, you know, it was his phone, he did not remember which account, and all sorts of craziness. But thank God I found a tutorial on YouTube how I could FRP unlock this device. But that is not what this video is about. This video is about you having this device and it's being on Android 5.11, and you're kind of still happy about how it works, because it does work nice on 5.11. It's official firmware, so yeah, there's nothing better existing in the world than that stock ROM that this thing was left on, I think somewhere in, not even sure. So if that is the case with you, and you would love to have, you know, you would like to play with it because you already bought another phone, and you just want to make something special from it, you want to install a custom ROM onto it, then that is possible, because we have a TWRP that was developed special for this phone. It's TWRP 2.8, by the way. I think there's an update, but I got into troubles with that update, so I'm not updating the TWRP. The TWRP is just fine for what it is. I will see if I will find a better 3.0 version. I think the version from the developer that created the Lineage OS, I think he has updated TWRP. But I'm gonna show the 2.8 that comes from twerp.me. Okay? So what is it? It's the Pink Floyd ROM. It looks amazing, and it has the Aurora store built in. It has no Google services, okay? I removed that. I made a light stock custom ROM. In fact, this is just the official ROM. Yeah, because nothing was changed in the development. Only things, you know, that I changed were removing certain applications out of the package. I pushed fantastic applications into the package. Another launcher, you have the One Touch UI launcher, UI launcher with everything built in. It's just one amazing, beautiful device now. So welcome to a new tutorial. Let's get started and let me show you what you should do. If you're still unstuck, you will need to download the TWRP. You will need to put the phone into a download mode, okay? And with Audin, you can then flash via AP the TWRP. During the reboot, immediately go into the recovery mode. But before doing that all, you will need to go into the developers options. How to find developers options? Go to settings and then find software information. And up there you must find build number and tap on it until it says you enabled developers options. For my Dutch people, that will be je hebt ontwikkelaars opties aangezet. Go back to the settings, all the way back where you found about this phone. And there you're gonna see developers options all the way at the bottom. Tap it and make sure that at the fourth tap you turn on Oom Unlock. Als je in developers ontwikkelaars opties gaat, moet je zorgen dat Oom, hoe heet het nou in het Nederlands? Dat je Oom Unlock aanzet. Het is de vierde tab. Iets met Oom. Zoek het maar even op. Ik weet niet hoe het heet in Nederlands. Maar in Engels is het Oom Unlock. Turn that on. Remove all the accounts. Verwijder al je accounts uit de telefoon. Oké? Je Google account, je Samsung account. It's very important to remove all the accounts. Otherwise, you're gonna be FRP locked. And then you will not be able to flash TWRP. It will give you an error. And it will say could not. Because there's some account hanging to the phone. So you must log out from all the accounts. Make a backup. You know, do all these things that you need to do. Then, you know, you will be able to install TWRP. And when you install TWRP, okay, we're gonna go from that point. You will be ready to install this ROM that I created from the stock ROM. Okay, so I used the last stock ROM for this device and I created a beautiful Pink Floyd modeled ROM for this device. It's one of a kind, and let's go ahead and install it. I think you have enough information. I will put the files for you. I will include the TWRP file because it will never be updated ever. So yeah, no need to, you know, give you two links. I will just pack everything that you need for this phone to, you know, to update it. Only thing that you will need to find are the Samsung USB drivers. Just type in Google Samsung USB drivers download. Go for the first link, you know, download these drivers. Make sure that it's saying samsung.com, okay? And you will need Audin. How to find Audin? Just type Audin 3.1111 download in Google, and then you're gonna find the links. Go to the official site to download Audin. So these two tools you must find on your own, and the flashing of the updating of the TWRP you will as well have to do on your own. We're gonna go to the installing part from where you already installed TWRP. Okay, there we are. As you can see, lovely modeled phone with latest future iOS look and feels. I think Apple does not have these things yet that we are showing here, so they might as well get some inspiration out of this. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna reboot the system, and I'm just gonna do a reboot like this, and I'm gonna hold up volume, home, and I'm gonna wait, and now press the power as well. So I'm holding these three buttons, and if we don't get into a battery, we see the logo. We let go of these three buttons. We see a red line here, means it's gonna reboot back into the Samsung logo, and now it's gonna go into the recovery. That's the procedure of this phone. Okay, and there we are. We have a TeamWin Recovery Project 2.87 installed. It's just fine. It's just fine for this ROM, okay? So what we're now gonna do is we're gonna do advanced wipe Dalvik catch system data. And we're going to wipe. All right, so we go back home. And now we're going to install. And we're going to install from the internal storage up a level. And there it is. Pink Floyd ROM for the G531F signed. Okay, this is a signed ROM, guys. So, yeah, there we go. And here you can see what it's saying. You should read here. Welcome and thanks for installing the remodeled Pink Floyd ROM, beautiful iOS X future styled with One Touch UI. It's official Samsung firmware by PuckerOM 2020. It's de-googled, but with the Aurora Store included for pure custom users that know how to get around an Android, and very smooth. Great apps included, such as a Power Amp, Radio Droid, Podcast, Hem Receiver, Scanner Radio, YouTube, Ultra Firewall, XDA app, Root Browser, Dolphin, Chromium Browser, Bitdefender, Copilot, Bitdefender Copilot, Antivirus, Malware Control, that is belongs to the Bitdefender, and of course the regular apps. Remember, no Google Play Store installed in this version. That version will come soon. Okay, so this is a light version. The total ROM is I think only 780 megabytes. Okay, and I created this ROM yesterday. I baked it. I did not create it. It was created by Samsung. By the way, those that want to use this as a model to create, you know, other styled and modeled ROMs, you have my permission to do that. Okay, I will not call any Kang over you, because this is Samsung firmware, and I just make a nice cake. And if you love the recipe of the cake, you are allowed to modify it and to make your own cake and give it your own name. You have my blessing. Have a nice day. Okay, so now we're gonna reboot the last system. I already told you this is the Pink Floyd ROM, and this is code name Brick in the Wall, because this phone is a brick in the wall. It cannot go nowhere. There's no development for it. And here you can hear the music playing on the background already. You will be having a great startup sound that will be very unique. There is no phone booting up like this. I think somewhere in the solo we're gonna arrive. You see, I tell you, I know my ROMs, man. I know my ROMs. We arrived, my friends. Most beautiful ROM. This thing boots faster than the original ROM from Samsung. No offense, Samsung. Respect to Samsung, you know. And now the music stopped. You see that? No ROM boots up like this. Telling you, peeps. So I'm just giving inspiration here, you know. I'm a YouTuber. I'm not a developer, but look what I got for you. What you must do after the reboot, you must just reboot it one more time, okay? That is the procedure. Because this thing became so fast now that the ROM, it must get used to being that fast. It does not believe it yet. And at the second boot, you know, it will start realizing that it really became something special. Booting up. You see? And when it boots up, it will keep playing the music a bit for you. You know, some people, they love to listen to some music here. Yeah, you can put it louder, system sound. So you will have some music playing while setting up the device. You know, I think that is really cool. There's no ROM in the world that comes like that. You can give it a notch. You can give it a locker. You should give it the locker. The locker is beautiful. There is no more beautiful locker than this. Look at this, man. Och, prachtig. And then
Yeah, some of you will be like, hey, this guy loves his own creations a whole lot. Yes, of course I do. Are you mad? Of course I do. I love my creations, man. If I don't love them, who's gonna love them? Need no education. Education. That is very British. All these things I'm gonna remove. So, what you should do, if you're a customer or user, then you must go to all apps. It's really important, okay? Because there are some leftovers that should be shut down. I could remove them, but I'm gonna let a friend of mine remove them all. These things, you see? There are some leftovers. All in all, it's just another brick in the wall. It's not the meaning to use this device with your accounts, okay? This is an accountless. This is only for true customer users, guys that know how to get around. This is not for people that's gonna cry for Google Play Store. Then you must wait for the next build, okay? I will make a build with Google services and everything built in, so you don't you know, you have it all. But then I'm scared that you're gonna use an outdated system with your accounts, and you know, it might get breached because the security updates of this device is kind of, you have Power Amp built in, but I have no music on this device. But I cannot get into the settings of my DAC. That is kind of strange. It's saying not recognized. Okay. I will look into that. But everything works. Let's connect to the internet real fast. Okay, we are connected to the internet. Lovely. So let's see how things are working. Let's go for YouTube. Let's see how YouTube works. If you're gonna install Google services, then this ROM, you must not install Google services on this ROM. Okay, please wait for my other ROM. You see that? Advertisements play fine. So we don't harm the YouTube platform with this, with this with this amazing application. Okay. You cannot be on a platform and then harm it. You understand? So you must as well think positive. We have Ultra Firewall if you're gonna root it. We have XDA app. XDA app will give you information about development about this phone and about other phones. It's a very nice app. I have it on all my mods and custom ROMs. You see that? This is the 530, but this is the 531F. There's no development for this phone. This is a Grand Prime. So yeah, everything works out of the box. Everything works good. Suriname. Radio Apenti. You see that? And SRS. You can find all the countries in the world. This is amazing, amazing device this thing became. Out of nothing, it already can do. We didn't download any app. This is what is all standard on the device, things that you can immediately do out of the box without needing to install anything. Okay, this one niet geladen werd. 9, okay. This one works fine. So it depends certain broadcasts are sometimes, you see, Richtlichten, that means rights. But then you can scroll down and, you know, you can watch something else. Everything works. See that? Amazing, huh? At least I think it's amazing. Good store. Aurora store. Next. Anonymous. And you are logged in and you can go ahead and download. Once in a while the Aurora store might stock up and then it's gonna reboot back into wherever you were. So you must take these things for granted, okay? These things, they happen once in a while. But that's just how it is. Sometimes it happens. Bitdefender antivirus that will let you inspect your device. You see that? And it will run as a co-pilot on the background. So if you download any malware or strange things, it will immediately pop up and let you know that something not good. Dolphin browser. A very nice browser that at least works whenever I push it in. Okay. It does not complain. It works nice. I can download things. I can read the internet. I can go read my news. I must first see it, then I believe it. Yeah. As you can see, the news works good. It's not laggy or so, it's pretty smooth, you know? I have no problem with this. And another reason why I have this app is ustvgo.tvgo. These guys will immediately load the site for me. And here I must say I agree, of course, accept all. And then I can hit my CNN. And watch CNN live. You know, and the other browsers are all failing. Chrome is failing to do this for me. It's as if Chrome don't want me to watch live TV. Come on, baby. Whether it's bribes to roll over. See that? Or an overdue makeover. Get all your pet essentials right when you need them. Probably my rotation. You see that? It works fine. I can watch live TV via the browser. So that's why, you see, I don't care that we cannot watch Dutch TV. I don't care about Dutch TV. I disabled my account long time ago, years ago. I let them turn off my cable TV because I don't need it. If you pay for TV in this time, that while you have an internet connection, you are idiot. Trust me. I don't watch TV anymore. I rather watch a film on a small screen than on a big TV. Really. I see it better on a small screen. Like a 15 inch or so. You okay, Mr. Small? Why are you looking at that painting like that? You see that? Everything works, man. So this is, I think, a nice improvement for this phone. The G531F here, you have the weather, you see that? You can put up your weather. And Suhanu Rahman just subscribed as well on my channel, so welcome, Rahman. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen. I think I showed more than enough. A beautiful ROM that you can install on the G531F, and I'm very proud to bring this to you. Remember, have fun with it. Well, that was it for the Pink Floyd ROM in the beautiful XS home screen. This is just something that does not exist, but it works and you can install it, and it even comes from official hands, and that's Samsung. They created the ROM. So if there's something not working, you don't call me, you call Samsung, okay? Just kidding. So your 531F is one beautiful phone that you don't have to be ashamed of anymore, right? By the way, I never showed the settings. In the settings, you will as well find some information about this, whatever I did. Toestel info. You can see it. The Android version, Pink Floyd L. And security updates is fini. Yeah, so that is all in there. So you can find information about whatever this thing is representing in look and feels. I wish you a fantastic day. Let the sun shine on for you. Stay healthy, stay out of trouble, and then I see you in the next video again. Bye bye.